In this section of the tutorial, we'll be covering Single Sign-On Setup. Single Sign-On, or SSO, allows your crowd to seamlessly and easily access your IdeaScale platform in accordance with organization-specific security protocols. SSO is important because it allows users an easy way to access the platform while adhering to specific security settings for your organization. You will need to be an IdeaScale administrator for this setup. We'll start by navigating over to Community Settings. And on the left-hand side, going to Security and Single Sign-On Settings. We want to first make sure that the Advanced toggle is switched on and that Single Sign-On Settings are turned on as well. From there, we can add a new configuration and select the Single Sign-On configuration for our organization. Most times, this will be SAML 2.0. We can get the IdeaScale metadata by opening a new tab and clicking on this link. We can then copy and paste this metadata for use in our organization. We'll enter a display name, a SAML IDP identity ID, and your organization's SAML IDP metadata. As we scroll down, we'll see a few additional optional settings that we can configure if we so desire. Please keep in mind, and please note, that you can save your IdeaScale single sign-on settings without enabling single sign-on. If you wish to set it up ahead of time and then test it, you can leave this disabled for the time being. When we're done, we will hit Save Changes. Once your single sign-on configuration has been created, you can come here and edit your existing configuration or map attributes to your IdeaScale community. The most common attributes that we see mapped are display name, preferred language, any member groups that you wish to create within IdeaScale, and username. You know that SSO will be set up successfully if you then go to log out and re-log in and see the screen.